Hello, my name is Dr. Nachum Ulanovsky. I'm a senior scientist at the Department of Neurobiology of the Weizmann Institute of Science. And we study in my lab brain areas that are very crucial for memory in general and spatial memory in particular. These areas are called the hippocampus and entorhinal cortex. And if those areas are damaged in people, then those patients cannot remember pretty much anything new, cannot learn new things. So we really want to understand this neural basis of memory. And we do this in somewhat unusual animals, in bats. We are the only lab in the world that studies these brain areas in bats. The reasons are that there are some things that you can do in bats that you cannot in standard animal models like rats or mice. So for example, you can ask how is three-dimensional space remembered or represented in the brain. To answer this question, people have tried already to do that. They've sent rats to space aboard a NASA space shuttle, but that experiment did not give conclusive questions. So what we did instead is we had the Weizmann Institute has built a really nice flight room, very large flight room, a unique facility in the world. And this allowed us, together with a spatial wireless neural recording device that we've developed, it allowed us to record for the first time from individual single neurons, nerve cells in the brain of bats during flight. And what we showed is that in the hippocampus, individual cells are active when the animal goes through a certain region of space, a certain three-dimensional region of space. It's kind of a sphere. These were the first ever recordings in a flying animal. This was a very challenging technological development. And this result was published a few months ago in Science magazine. Some other directions that we've taken is to ask how animals navigate in the wild. You cannot take a laboratory rat or mouse and let it run in the wild. They will not survive there. So instead we took bats, which are wild animals, and we equipped them with the tiny GPS data logger, the smallest GPS device in the world. And this GPS tracked their navigation in the wild. And what we found is that they navigate really long distances, tens of kilometers, going to the same individual tree night after night, returning to the same tree again and again. So they had really fantastic navigational abilities. And this was published recently in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences of the USA. And we've also done some studies on the sonar of bats, or the so-called echolocation, how they steer their echolocation beam in space, a study that was published 3 years ago and also in Science magazine. Again, I want to stress that this is not just stamp collection. We don't just study in another animal just to understand the bats per se, but on the contrary, we ask questions that are very fundamental in brain research, but are difficult to answer in standard animal models like rats, mice, or humans. And we use the spatial properties and behaviors of the bats in order to answer those very fundamental questions. Thank you.